If you're a Python developer, you may find yourself needing to extract data from websites at some point. And you might be thinking, well, I could just use an API to do that. Unfortunately, not all websites offer an API, or their API is prohibitively expensive, and that's where web scraping comes in. Web scraping is essentially a way to automate the process of extracting data from the web. And as a Python developer, you have access to some of the best libraries and frameworks available to help you get the job done. In this video, we'll take a look at some of the most popular Python libraries and frameworks for web scraping and compare their pros and cons so you know exactly what tool to use to tackle any web scraping project you might come across. First up, let's talk about HTTP libraries. These are the foundation of web scraping since every web scraping job starts by making a request to a website and retrieving its contents, usually as HTML. Two popular HTTP libraries in Python are requests and HTTPX. Requests is easy to use and great for simple scraping tasks, while HTTPX offers some advanced features like async and HTTP2 support. Their core functionality and syntax are very similar, so I would recommend HTTPX even for smaller projects, since you can easily scale up in the future without compromising performance. Once you have the HTML content, you need a way to parse it and extract the data you're interested in. Beautiful Soup is the most popular HTML parser in Python, allowing you to easily navigate and search through the HTML tree structure. Its straightforward syntax and easy setup also make Beautiful Soup a great option for small to medium web scraping projects, as well as web scraping beginners. The two major drawbacks of Beautiful Soup are its inability to scrape JavaScript-heavy websites and its limited scalability, which results in low performance in large-scale projects. For large projects, you would be better off using Scrapy, but more about that later. Next, let's take a look at how Beautiful Soup works in practice. We start by sending an HTTP GET request to the specified URL using the HTTPX library. Then, we save the retrieved content to a variable. Now we use the Beautiful Soup library to parse the HTML content of the web page. This enables us to manipulate the parsed content using Beautiful Soup methods, such as find all to find the content we need. In this particular case, we are finding all elements with the class a thing, which represents articles on Hacker News. Next, we simply loop through all the articles on the page and then use CSS selectors to further specify what data we would like to extract from each article. Finally, we print the scrape data to the console. What if the website you're scraping relies on JavaScript to load its content? In that case, an HTML parser won't be enough, as you'll need to generate a browser instance to load the page's JavaScript using a browser automation tool like Selenium or Playwright. These are primarily testing and automation tools that allow you to control a web browser programmatically, including clicking buttons, filling out forms, and more. However, they are also often used in web scraping as a means to access dynamically generated data on a web page. While Selenium and Playwright can be very similar in their core functionality, Playwright is more modern and complete than Selenium. For example, Playwright offers some unique built-in features such as automatically waiting on elements to be visible before making actions and an asynchronous version of its API using async.io. To exemplify how we can use Playwright to do web scraping, let's quickly walk through a code snippet where we use Playwright to extract data from an Amazon product and save a screenshot of the page while at it. Import the necessary modules, async.io and async.playwright, from Playwright's async API. After importing the necessary modules, we start by defining an async function called main that launches a Firefox browser instance with headless mode set to false, so we can actually see the browser working. We create a new page in the browser using the new page method, and finally navigate to the Amazon website using the goto method. Next, we define a list of CSS selectors for the data we want to be scraped. Then we can use the method async.io.gather to simultaneously execute the page.querySelector method on all the selectors in the list and store the results in a book data variable. Now we can iterate over book data to populate the book dictionary with the scraped data. Note that we also check that the element is not none and only add the elements which exist. This is considered good practice since websites could make small changes that would affect your scrape. You could even expand on this example and write more complex tests to ensure the data being extracted is not missing any values. Finally, we print the book dictionary contents to the console and take a screenshot of the scraped page, saving it as a file called book.png. As a last step, we make sure to close the browser instance. But wait, if browser automation tools can be used to scrape virtually any web page, and on top of that can also make it easier for you to automate tasks, test, and visualize your code working, why don't we just always use Playwright or Selenium for web scraping? Well, despite being a powerful scraping tool, these libraries and frameworks have a noticeable drawback. It turns out that generating a browser instance is a very resource-heavy action when compared to simply retrieving the page's HTML. This can easily become a huge performance bottleneck for large scraping jobs, which will not only take longer to complete, but also become considerably more expensive. For that reason, we usually want to limit the usage of these tools to only the necessary tasks, and when possible, use them together with Beautiful Soup or Scrapy. Next up, we have the most popular and arguably powerful web scraping framework for Python. If you find yourself needing to scrape large amounts of data regularly, then Scrapy could be a great option. The Scrapy framework offers a full-fledged suite of tools to aid you even in the most complex scraping jobs. On top of its superior performance when compared to Beautiful Soup, Scrapy can also be easily integrated into other data processing Python tools and even other libraries, such as Playwright. Not only that, but it comes with a handy collection of built-in features catered specifically to web scraping, such as a powerful and flexible spidering framework, support for handling common web data formats, extensible architecture, distributed scraping, error handling, support for authentication and cookies, and integration with other Python tools. Here's an example of how to use a Scrapy spider to scrape data from a website. The code example uses Scrapy to scrape data from the Hacker News website. Let's break down the code step by step. After importing the necessary modules, we define the spider class we want to use. Next, we set the spider properties: name, allowed domains, and starred URLs. Then we define the parse method. This method is the entry point for the spider and is called with the response of the URLs specified in starred URLs. In the parse method, we will extract data from the HTML response. The response object represents the HTML page received from the website. The spider uses CSS selectors to extract relevant data from the HTML structure. Now we use a for loop to iterate over each article found on the page. Finally, for each article, the spider extracts the URL, title, and rank information using CSS selectors and yields a Python dictionary containing this data. So, which library should you use for your web scraping project? The answer depends on the specific needs and requirements of your project. Each web scraping library and framework presented here has a unique purpose in our Scraper's toolkit. Learning to use each one will give us the flexibility to select the best tool for each job. That's all for this video. If you found it useful, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell for more content. So long, and thanks for all the likes.